And wow, welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, and we are entering the Vailian Embassy. I love how we get experience every time we come across a new place.
Laying low.
No problem.
Books. Galven Regd. Huh. Mention the name Regd in Ir Glanfath and you'll be told stories of a glorious freedom fighter, an Orlin who used his tactical savvy and battle training to protect the Glanfathen from the encroaching evil of the invaders in the Deerwood. Ask someone in the Deerwood about him and you'll hear angry retellings of the exploits of an underhanded, dirty-fighting Orlin who terrorized Deerwooden citizens. The conflict is what legends are built on, and Galven Regd? Regd? I don't know. Is the stuff of legends. The Broken Stone War began from a misunderstanding between the Glanfathens who lived in the Deerwood and the Iden colonists who were moving in. Tensions were already high between the two groups, as the Iderians claimed land the Glanfathens said they already owned. To it, the Glanfathens taken and forced into slavery by the Iderians, and it was only a matter of time before something snapped and sent the two groups to war. There was the occasional skirmish or fight between isolated groups, but no real conflict until the Broken Stone War. Whether intentional or not, Iderian farmers, clearing land for their crops, knocked over and destroyed one of the ancient menhirs that dot the countryside. The Glanfathens, who revered the ancient structures in the Deerwood, reacted swiftly and violently, led by a particularly fanatical fang by the name of Regd. Sorry guys, the way the sentence structure is just throwing me today. While the war was short-lived and the Glanfathens were ultimately not the victors, Regd and his forces were able to eliminate a vast, significant number of colonists. After the war ended, Regd was appointed the Galven, or leader, of the Glanfathen tribes. His leadership skills and prowess in battle earned him the respect of all the tribes of Ir Glanfath. Because all the tribes were unified behind him, he was able to move and coordinate their warriors in a way that organized them into such an efficient team. The Iden colonists lived in fear of his next attack. His name and reputation spread through both lands. Over 2 years following the Broken Stone War, Regd and his forces, using deception, misinformation, and straightforward guerrilla tactics, killed hundreds. The remaining earls send word to the Fair Koning, saying something must be done before more nobility is killed, but Regd continues to terrorize the colonists, and it seems that the campaign will never end. That is, until he encountered Edrang Hadret. Hello? Vincent Agosti?
Good day, stranger.
What can this humble servant of the Republics do for you? Tell me about the Vailian Republics. They are rich in all ways, in wealth, in style, in culture. If you were to go to the Republics, you would not want to leave. Why would you? The people are beautiful and charming. I am here because the Sangreta Ducal wishes it, but when my appointment is done, I will be on the first ship out, and I will sing from here to Salona. If there's nothing else, I must return to my duties. Speaking of your duties, yes, there is something else. What do you do here? As the Vailian ambassador, my job is to ensure trade with the Deerwood remains strong and profitable. Fare thee well. You have business with the Republics? Vailian diplomat. Being assigned to the embassy in Defiance Bay is an immense honor. Local politics only matter if they disrupt the flow of trade. I can't get this stuff. Scroll of prayer against restraint.
Hello. Hello?
Hello.
Hello.
These postings show current prices for a range of commodities, and they track the running exchange rate for the Vailian louche. Nothing much to do around here, is there? The Republics will more than welcome any of Defiance Bay's animancers if animancy were to be banned. What passes for Vailian cuisine in this city is pathetic. Spread across the table are the blueprints of an in-progress trade deal between a merchant company from the Republics and a Deerwooden Weirwool Collective. The flag depicts the symbol of the Vailian Republics, a ship sailing between five radiant stars. We can't get in that. We don't have the mechanics necessary. And we only have two lockpicks. There's no one in here. We don't have the lockpicks we need to get in here. We need more lockpicks.
Time to see and not be seen.
A simple test. A simple test.
Yep. We're low on lockpicks for that. Selected correspondences of Giftbringer Iden. Sing, O ocean waves, of Andra's sorrow, of her unrequited love for the unattainable moon. Sing of the ocean's sorrow so that we may forget our own. Each day the tides reenact Andra's longing for the great moon. The waters reach out at high tide. Ooh. Okay. That was interesting. That came out of nowhere. I've never heard that theme or sound. That's pretty cool. Why did it start now? Right. Each day the tides reenact Andra's longing for the great moon. The waters reach out at high tide, yearning for the heavenly body, only to slump into low tide when the moon proves unattainable. You asked me once why I loved Andra so dearly, how I could go from a life on dry land to being a devotee of the goddess of the oceans. I sing of the ocean's sorrow. I lost my way when I scrolled there. Hold on. What is it with me? I sing of the ocean's sorrow so that I may forget my own. It is Andra's message that speaks to my heart. I have devoted my life to helping others discard painful memories, for that is the gift Andra gave me. When I lost my young daughter, my wife and I were inconsolable until a gift bearer offered to take my toddler's toys and cast them into the deepest waters. Truth be told, I and the other gift bearers I know have never even spoken to Andra. She is largely silent, and when she does speak, she uses floods and tidal waves instead of words. This must be some angry words. But we sing of the ocean's sorrow so that others may forget theirs. Andra's story, the story of desire unanswered, actually matters to people like you and me. Magrin cannot steer you to victory over sadness. Hylia cannot force joy down a crying throat. Only Andra can give us the strength to persevere when life seems without worth. And that is why the answer to your question regarding why I love my goddess so dearly. Well, that is the answer to your question regarding why I love my goddess so dearly. That's cool. I guess we're done. I figured we'd just be spending a lot of time in here or something. Since there's only like three buildings in this district. 10 minutes and we're done. I guess we'll go to the castle next. We have a quest to do in the Crucible Knights building, so... So I will go to the Ducal Palace now. I know I can go there and, like, click. You know, just click there and have them go, but it's kind of boring to have you guys just sit there and... I don't feel like editing out the crap, so just watch me walk over here. As if that's so much more interesting, but hey. Better than nothing. So yeah, Ducal Palace. Hello. So I keep checking down here to see if anyone levels up or wants to speak with us. Ta-ling! Sidley!
Welcome.
The young woman wears a simple but well-tailored uniform. She watches the comings and goings around her with quiet attention. Any news to share? Or are you just here to see the Ducal Palace? Who are you? I'm a page here at the palace. I deliver messages and run errands for the Duke and his advisors. The pay's not great, but I can't think of a better introduction to politics. Looking for news? What goes on in here? She laughs. Where to start? We've got meetings, public hearings, and ceremonies, and that's just the stuff that happens out in the open. She leans a little closer. This is where the Duke and his key advisors work, so there's always someone bartering for a favor. Unfortunately, I'm not at liberty to talk about that side of things. But if you want the official version, she clears her throat and gestures counterclockwise around the palace. We have a shrine devoted to Magwin, official records, and chambers for public hearings and council meetings. Tell me about the Shrine of Magwin. It's a symbol of Magwin's protection of Defiance Bay. She's represented the revolutionary spirit of the Deerwood ever since her independence, or since independence, and her involvement in creating the Godhammer bomb only affirmed her importance to us. She scratches her neck. That's also where the first of the sacred fires burn, but Firga, the tranquil ardent, has had trouble keeping them lit. What kinds of records are stored here? Mostly dull official stuff, census counts, tax records, militia registers. Now, I keep my distance. I got curious one day and got drafted into reshelving half of the records. She yawns. Worst day of my life. Is there a hearing going on right now? Sure is. Duke Eivor has been meeting with some of the city leaders for weeks now, trying to figure out how to address the legacy. The whole business is terribly secret, though. I tried to sit in the gallery during my lunch break one day and got turned away. She sniffs, but a lot of the talk concerns animancy, so there's good reason they're keeping the meetings behind closed doors. The legacy? Widewind's legacy. That's what a lot of people call the Rash of Hollowborn. The theory goes that it's punishment for meddling in animancy. Oh my god, excuse me guys. This is what happens when you drink a lot of Starbucks Frappuccinos. What are Hollowborn? I know we know all this, but I just want to hear what she has to say about it. She raises an eyebrow. You really are fresh from the road. Hollowborn are children born without souls. They often don't live for very long, and those that do have generally received some kind of treatment from the animancers. Why is animancy so controversial? She laughs. Where to begin? Traditionalists think it's a crime against the gods. There's no question that poking around in souls is risky, but the more progressive elements believe it's our only shot at restoring healthy births. And it doesn't help matters that animancy research often involves old Anguithan relics that were illegally looted from ruins near Glanfath. She makes a quick, twitching motion with her index and middle fingers. So what do you think about animancy? Me? I think the real danger of animancy is confusing a real scholar with an expensive fake. We get a new case here every day. Some poor couple in the Gift or Copperline who spent every copper they had on a miracle cure for their unborn child. It never works. She shakes her head. Breaks your heart, but there's usually nothing we can do for them. I see. Anyway, the legacy is what the politicians have all been whispering about lately. OK. Okay, never mind. I thought there was another option we didn't explore, but we actually did, so... to ask about something else... What is the Ducal Palace? It's the seat of government here in Defiance Bay. This is where Duke Admeth Hadret declared freedom from Adiran rule some 150 years ago. She lowers her voice and grins. It's also a hotbed of regional politics. Trust me, the gossip here beats what you'd find in any tavern or brothel in the city. Kenna says, Ah, Deerwood politics. It changes too quickly to be worth keeping up with. Better to strike up conversation in the taverns than try to loiter inconspicuously in the palace corridors. Tell me about the current duke. That would be Eivor Wulfgrin. Don't let the title fool you, though. Our dukes have been elected since independence. Some find Duke Eivor rather coarse. He's a frontier noble. Personally, I think a rough and rumble type is just what Defiance Bay needs. All right. See ya. Ooh, we got something in there. How do we get in there? Justiciars. No matter what goes on out there, this palace is a symbol of local pride for Defiance Bay. The Crucible Knights weren't always soldiers. We used to be blacksmiths. I thought he was saying something we've seen before. We can go in here. And there's no one in here. Just in case. We sneak anyway. Huh. Truth be told, I don't see a reason to steal that stuff. I mean, we could just haul stuff, but I personally find it kind of stupid to do that. And, not really plausible. Only people with official invitations are allowed to observe the animancy hearings. Oh, come on, we have an invitation. I invite myself. Does this go down? Doesn't say. Down, out. You know, there is a side entrance that probably goes there. So quiet in here. Ferga. A stone figure of a warrior gazes towards her raised hand. It's empty, but the palm and fingers are blackened. Most bright Magrin, transform us with your flame, she says. Firga.
Good day to you.
The woman's head is bowed as her lips move in prayer. Just as you approach, you catch her glimpsing at the statue near her. She notices you and forces a smile. Praise be to Magrin, and welcome to her temple. How may I be of service? Huh. You seem upset. What's wrong? Her shoulders slump. This is about the fires, isn't it? She puts a hand on your shoulder. They're just symbols. You can't put your faith in them. I do number three, but I don't know what she's talking about. The fires? She sighs. The sacred pyres all around town. You must have seen the statues of the goddess around the city, holding up empty braziers. I've kept them burning steadily for 15 years, but I haven't been able to conjure them for months now, and people need to see them more than ever these days. What does that mean? It's my devotions and prayers to keep them lit, but lately when I try to pray, all I can think about are the Hollowborn all over the city, the grieving families, the refugees. She shakes her head. How could Magrin allow us to suffer like this? What strength do we gain from a soulless child? Okay, Durrance, you've got to have something to say. We've keep running across Magrin stuff and you've been quiet. Here he is. No, I have not played this game before, guys. I have not seen this scene before. Durrance grunts with disdain. What strength do we gain from adversity? From trial and test? The fires don't wither because she lacks in faith. They wither because she does not understand how to be faithful to a whore. A whore wants neither praise nor devotion. Ahura wants to be compensated for her services, and Magrin is paid and pleasured in struggle and pain. This mewling imbecile is unworthy of Magrin's womanly heat. Okay, I guess we're not answering him. We're talking to her. And this has shaken your faith? Fira nods, running her hands through her hair. But I believe Magrin may be speaking to me again. She frowns and casts a quick glance in your direction. Lately I've been seeing visions, a place in the wilderness with pools filled with sunbursts of color. Strange falls that seem to rise to the heavens even while they splash into the earth. She raises her hands as if framing an image of her vision. And behind the falls is a cave, filled with fire and heat and danger, and some token of my goddess. I know there's something there, but where it is, or how I'd get there... She shakes her head. I've been meaning to ask around at the expedition hall to see if anyone recognizes the description. To be honest, though, I don't know what I'd do, even if I found the place. Durin says, worthless, like so many of Magrin's flock. Afraid of her god's tests. If Magrin speaks to her, it is to hasten an end to a hypocrite's life, and this vision is surely a death trap for the weak. Durin's really pulling no punches, does he? What's the significance of the sacred pyres? They symbolize Magrin's power and guidance, and right now the people of Defiance Bay need to be assured of her presence. She crosses her arms, staring at the statue. Only neighbors in the Vailian Republic see us as superstitious, but we're just sensitive to the signs and warnings of the gods. Something else? I'd like to know more about the temple here. Magrin is the most revered goddess among us dear Woodens, so it's no surprise that her temple is part of the Ducal Palace. Her fires symbolize trials, revolutions, and the blazing of new paths, all of which are important to us. She gestures to the statue. This is the first of the sacred pyres. When this is lit, so are the rest around the city. All right. Bye. Okay, so we got a quest. Travel to the cave from Firga's vision. Someone to the expedition hall might know. I'm not going to read all this. I found a map pinpointing the location of a place called Searing Falls. That's quick. Oh. Is that map we found? So we found the map before we found her. Where is this map? So we can't look at this. I'd love to actually look at this map rather than see a description of it. Okay. Alright. I am gonna try to get in here, but let's look up here first. Yeah, I'm sure we'll get in that box. So many refugees come here fleeing the legacy. I doubt they realize that it struck us, too. Animancy isn't the problem. It's the solution to all our ills. The common folk don't appreciate the sacrifices we've made to try and end this. It's a lot of these scrolls of prayer against restraint that we can't get into. I mean, I wonder if we could, actually.
My eyes are peeled.
I doubt it. I mean, they're facing that way. And they're facing that way. There's no way.
Yeah?
I need a superior rogue to be able to do something like that. Is this another way? Oh, it's another way in. You may not enter the audience chamber while council is in session without an invitation. Okay, we need to find an invitation. We're responsible for the safety of every person in the city. That's nice. Records keeper.
Hmm? I'll see what I can find.
What?
There's no way. No freaking way. We need a roguey type. I need to find a roguey type next. Alright, so I don't even want to look at this stuff and tease myself. Let's just talk to the records keeper.
Gods keep you.
A taciturn man with graying hair pores over a tome he's just withdrawn from one of the shelves. He glances up at you with baggy eyes. Yes? Is there something I can pull for you? Okay. I am looking for militia records from the time of the Saints' War, trying to find out what happened to someone. The man clears his throat. We've had a number of inquiries about such information. I'm afraid we've had to bar access to the public. Seems there are still a number of folk in Deerwood who bear ill will towards Red Sarans. It would be irresponsible to surrender their names to just anyone. Many came to settle here as refugees. Perhaps if you were more established in Defiance Bay, things would be different. But I have no reason to suspect you to be any different from the others. What would we do with might? Like, pick the guy up and throw him across the room, and now will you give it to us? I don't think I would do that to him anyway, with all those guards over there. Unless if it's maybe like a spiritual, like soul, like kind of like a mite of an inner spirit that could, you know, I don't know, make him afraid to defy us. We've come a long way. Ida says, I just need to find out about my brother. I don't even know what side he fought for. Oh, I forgot about Eder's little quest thing. You must understand. I have heard many such stories. I'm afraid there's nothing I can do for you. Yeah. Pissant.
Hmm.
Suspected as such. I really don't want to press my luck. I'm going to save the game and see about getting in there. We need an invitation, dammit. Unlocking this will require the proper key. Yep, same. Yep, I thought so.
Your brother, did you and he get along?
We got along how brothers do. He used to throw water on me to wake me up in the morning. I used to fill his boots with stinging ants.
My own brothers and sisters are doing very well for themselves, back in Tacoa. I don't know that they'd search for me if I were killed so far from home.
Brothers can be funny. I bet you'd be surprised how far they'd go.
Spoken very well. So that's it for the Vailian Embassy and the Ducal Palace. Figured we'd be spending a lot of time in there for some reason. Let's head our way down to the Crucible Keep. Who that? Commoner. Vailian diplomat. Being assigned to the embassy in Defiance Bay is an immense honor. These purple weren't out before because it was nighttime. Have you been to the Expedition Hall yet? You might find your type of work there. Won't be long before we're a formal knighthood. Okay, where are we exactly? Okay. Anything over here? Tucked away? Nope. Alright. Seems like a good place to stop off. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode when we enter Crucible Keep. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.